Hey, thank you for tuning in again. This is Kurt with Traverse Tool Company. Today we're going to talk about threading. We're going to both tap a hole and thread a rod. For this video, we're only going to talk about tapping by hand. We're not going to use a machine for either the tapping or the external threading. Now we're going to tap something, but in order to tap something, you need a hole. So I need to put a hole a half inch in from this edge and a half inch down from that edge and tap it. So first I'm going to take this cardboard to protect the material. This is a really coarse jaw, so that'll keep the material from getting damaged. So I need to mark where the hole is going to be, half inch down and over. So first I'm just going to use just a regular old rail wide marker, set my calipers at half inch, lock it in there, and scribe my mark. There's where I need it. Now I have a center punch, and that's where I need the hole. Since I have such a small prick mark, I'm just going to use a small center drill. And that'll be plenty. Next, I'm going to put the drill . Need some cutting oil on it. This is aluminum, so you should never cut aluminum dry. Now I'm going to put in a countersink. Slow it down. I'm not going to countersink the hole, but I just want to put a little chamfer on it. And that's perfect. The tap I'm going to use for this is the taper tap, because that's going to give me the best possibility for getting that in there as straight as possible. Okay, well, I didn't think this one all the way through because my tap handle's hitting the vise. So I'm just gonna move the workpiece material over, keep that cardboard in place. That should do it. And I think that'll work. With a straight flute tap, which is what we're using here, once you get it going, you have to back it up a little bit just to break the chip. So give it maybe a half a turn and back it off, and I have to move it out a little bit more because I'm still hitting the vise. There we go. And there it is. Now let's talk about threading a rod. There are two main types of dies that you do that with. One has a round outside diameter and the other one has a hex. We're going to use a round one. I need to thread this rod just a little bit past that hole. So I'm going to clamp it in the vise. It's important that you start it straight, because if you start it crooked, it won't straighten itself out. With about every half turn, just like with tapping with a straight flute tap, you have to reverse it to break the chips. Bit more. And I think that'll do it. So let's see how we did. And that's a good fit. And that's all that's to it. Thank you for watching. I hope this video was educational to you. Hope that there was a takeaway from it that'll be helpful. Feel free to like and subscribe and tune in again soon.